Hey guys, Tyler here. This month is a humongous month for fans of Tokusatsu.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
As you guys can probably tell by the title of this video, I'm gonna talk about the various Tokusatsu releases that are gonna come out on both August and October. And I think the main reason why there are just so many releases right now as I speak is because mainly many companies want to bank on the fact that I guess, you know, movies like Godzilla is popular again. And so that's why they want to cash in onto like the Tokusatsu releases. And so I guess without further delay, here are some of the announcements that I want to share with you guys. The first major announcement is the fact that Mill Creek Entertainment has announced that they acquire most of the library of the Ultraman series. And starting in October, they're going to release both Ultra Q and Ultraman on Blu-ray at the same time on both Standard Edition and also Steelbook Editions. This news is humongous for a multitude of different reasons. Like for starters, many of the Ultraman shows has never, and I repeat ever, had a legal release in North America. Like basically, for a lot of these shows, they've never been released in high definition either. So it'll be the first time that Ultra Q and Ultraman will be released in high definition. It is also the first time, of course, that these shows will be released, period, in North America. That aspect is exciting. Also, I'm kind of curious on whether or not, like, basically Mill Creek will release the English dubs for these releases. Mostly because, basically, I know for a fact that a lot of these Ultraman shows have produced various English dubs throughout the history of the shows. For example, although Ultraman was released state-wise, Ultra Q, although it was never released in the States, also got an English dub. To my knowledge, the English dub of Ultra Q has never got a legit release, so I'm kind of curious if Mill Creek Entertainment is going to release the English dub of Ultra Q or just have a subtitle. Either way, I'm really happy about this news because it could finally have this show in high definition. The next major releases obviously had to do with Godzilla. Warner Brothers Pictures is going to release the 4K, the 3D, and the Blu-ray editions of Godzilla King of the Monsters. On top of the release of the 2019 movies, the first 15 Godzilla movies will also be released onto Blu-ray by the Criterion Collection. This special edition will include, but not limited to, a lot of stuff, including a hardcover book with essays, the Japanese cuts of the movie, as well as some audio commentaries for the first Godzilla movie, some interviews with the filmmakers of the movies, the actors in the movies, and some of the English dubs that were produced for the movies. Another curious aspect about the set is the fact that the Japanese cut of King Kong vs. Godzilla would also be featured. You're probably thinking to yourself, well, geez, Tyler, what is so special about the Japanese cut of King Kong vs. Godzilla? Now, hear me out for a second here. Just hear me out for a second. The Japanese cut of this movie has never, ever got an official release in this country. Ever. Like, basically, the only country that had, like, the Japanese cut of this movie was Japan. And for the longest time, for many years, fans of America had to get bootlegs to see this movie in a Japanese cut. So this is the first ever official release of the Japanese cut of this movie. The final major release announcement that I have for you guys is a Japanese tokusatsu show called Jaspion. Personally, I never heard about this show, but apparently it's really popular in Brazil. So to recap, we have the first 15 Godzilla movies, we have the new Godzilla movie, we have Ultraman, Ultra Q, and Jaspion. Like, basically, August and October is really set for kaiju fans. And also coming out next year is the remake for King Kong vs. Godzilla. Now, apparently there was some disappointment for some fans, mostly because Child Factory was supposed to announce some sort of license of a Super Sentai show. However, they did not announce it because apparently, according to some fans, the main reason why they have not announced it is because of Hasbro. However, I'm not really sure about that news, if it's true or not. But what are you guys' thoughts about these announcements? Please tell me in the comment section down below. And I'll talk to you guys next time. Take care.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.